brand new two lamp.
That's not good.
That was funny, Sean. Ordered
so
this
cool.
tile
we're gonna find this
from
again.
Mexico, and it's handmade. Good morning, everyone. I'm Nina, and this is my home. My husband and I bought three and a half years ago now, and we've done a lot to it, and I'd like to introduce you to it and show you little things. Come this way. First of all, we have a large double garage. Right now it's full with infrastructure for our chickens and for my husband's shop. He's an artist and a craftsman, so it's full of wood and stuff that we have to remove, but as you can see, he has windows in the front, so we have a nice southern exposure. He has a nice warm spot to work. Over here is our playhouse. We have eight grandchildren, and they have their own yard where we put a pool in the summer, and they have a playhouse to play in. It also provides privacy into our gardens. So back here, we've invested in a little permaculture. We have grapes, two kinds. We have cherries over here. We have an herb garden, roses are pink and yellow. Hi, this is the entrance to our house, and as you can see, you can enter the basement here. We have a full basement. We've updated electrical and plumbing since we've been here. From here, we'll just grab a piece of wood. I'd like to throw it in the stove. We use wood to heat our home, as well as a brand new heat pump sitting over there on the wall. This is my cook stove, and we use this all day long. I cook on it. I have a roast in the oven, and I have a warming drawer to keep food warm. This is a chef's kitchen. My husband and I were both chefs in our career, so we'll get to that in a moment. We put a brand new heat pump in, and in the evening, we usually let the stove die down, and we run the heat pump. Electric bill's $151 a month, equalized over the whole year. So it's a very efficient home. We took down walls and we opened it up. We like the open concept that it provides for us and our family. Over here, you'll see that for all of those knickknacks and things that every person has, my husband has built me a lovely mid-century modern bookcase that I'm able to put all our stuff on. And it just gives us a little storage here. He has done a lovely wainscoting treatment through the den, and then into the kitchen as well has the wainscoting. We have a lot of tile in this home. My husband is a very, very efficient at tile. He's also very efficient at storage. So as you'll notice here, all of my spices and cooking things are here. All of my wood for cooking is here. And then when you come around, my island, he built this a year ago. So this island was built each year that we've been here. In January after Christmas, we've done a large project. This last year was the island. So that means my dishwasher is exactly 1 year old. We have extremely large drawers on soft close hinges that holds all of my baking goods, my flours, my sugars, all of my colors, do a lot of wedding cakes and that type of thing. So this drawer is all customized to fit that. And as you can see, soft close. The induction burners are seriously easy to cook with. All of the pots and pans work with the induction burners and can go with the home. Now, we had the electrician in. He wired this for the island. It has no other circuits on the home on it, so we are able to put all of our appliances here. Having two chefs in the home, we need a lot of appliance storage, because not only do we make wedding cakes, we also grow and can all of our own food off the property. So we have two appliance garages, both, again, on soft close hinges, as you can see. So the countertop was done 2 years ago as well, and this sink just came for Christmas. We have a new baby, and I like to bath my baby in the kitchen sink, so there, I got a brand new kitchen sink for that. Come into the, now this is the...
Oh, before we go in there, I'm jumping in here, Nina, and I gotta say, this view right here is awesome. I gotta show you this, and you saw it coming from the other way. The other way is actually my favorite view in the house.
Don't you love the tile?
And, oh, the tile's... This, wow, so unique.
I ordered
so
this
cool.
tile
we're gonna find this
from
again.
Mexico, and it's handmade and it's hand painted, so each tile is a little bit different.
Cool.
So it was a challenge to put up. It
Even
took us a long time.
Here, to, right?
Well, thank
just
you.
Just the thought to go with that pattern, so.
It took days to lay that out on the floor and pick a pattern.
And the other thing I can't not mention is this cool rounded cabinet.
Well,
this is unique for sure, and I love how you kept the original cabinet.
We like to try to save as much character of the home as possible. So, I'm a real pantry girl, and this is my pantry. He put up a little shelf here for me to put stuff on and tile because the garbage goes here, and you know what kids are like, it's easy to keep clean. So this is the pantry. So this is the spare room, Sean. And we have a sliding door, which is very popular. And it is a large room. Now in the fall, here in New Brunswick, as you know, our COVID laws can be very tight, and we've been on red for quite some time and orange. So my husband built this so that we could have enough storage if we needed it to be able to stay to 3 to 6 months as we were asked. So we have food. Plus this is all my canned goods that I canned. That's what I have left from my garden last year. The master closet. Now this closet is very large, and because we needed space for our grandchildren, we turned it into a bunkie. But it can easily come back to a closet, or what I would do with it is I would make it a second master bath.
Very cool idea to turn that into one.
I think so. So my husband put this door here. Isn't it beautiful? And this bathroom was like 14 feet long and this wide, and the toilet was here and everything else was down there. So we decided to go ahead and put a wall in and another sink, so we ended up with 1.5 bath. It's still under construction, but we've had the plumber and electrical in and that's all done. So now my husband is just finishing up the construction part, which is his deal. So come this way. As you can see, the other half has become a beautiful ensuite in our master. We have a little bit more work to finish, some trimming out and some painting and put up the light fixture, but we're just about there and we're very pleased with how it came out. This master bedroom is extremely large and comfortable. The other thing that did was it gave us an eastern and a western light for this room that really makes the master a comfortable place. In the morning you can lay there and watch the sun come up, and in the evening you can watch the sun go down from your master. This is a huge king-size bed, the biggest I could buy, and there's still two large tables on each side, as well as dresser and makeup table. Now, I'm going to allow you to go into the closet and take a look. He has turned that into the best closet a girl could ever ask for. There's enough room for all my shoes and all my hats and all my dresses and all my jewelry. So that's pretty much the tour of our home. We're very, very much in love with it. We hate to see it go. I'd like to see someone come along that would like to continue on with the permaculture. And we have grapes and apples, raspberries, strawberries, as well as multiple flower gardens from, you know, trees to peonies. So anyone that's into permaculture or into gardening, into a very relaxed lifestyle. We built this home. It takes me an hour every day to clean it, and then the rest of the time is mine. I can go to the beach because we have absolutely beautiful beaches here where you can pick glass, or you can go swimming in our warm saltwater beach, or you can just hang out in the yard. We have a beautiful private area in the back. We have a full acre back there, and you can spend your time looking into the forest. We have 8 female deer in a herd and 1 male, so they come by every night and look for snacks in the yard. And we have tons of birds. We have bluebirds, we have blackbirds, we have a pair of pileated woodpeckers out here that for 3 years now have given us babies that we really enjoy in that tree, which is why we haven't taken that tree down. But it's a very natural, easy lifestyle here, and we truly enjoy it, and we hope that whoever comes along and decides that they would like to take over our spot will really love our home and will enjoy the custom and the craftsmanship that my husband has put into it.